Hi, and welcome to the Assemblines podcast. I'm Chris Torrance. In today's episode, I want to continue my review of the A2FPGA card from Reactive Micro and take a look at how the card performs in the Apple IIGS. So let's get started. We're now going to try the A2FPGA in my Apple IIGS. To do that, we need to change one of the DIP switches. So if you recall, there are four switches on the card. The first one controls whether it shows scan lines or not. The second one is whether to route the Apple II's internal speaker out to the HDMI. The third one is to turn on or off the 2 second boot delay. And finally, the fourth one is for the IIGS. So we'll go ahead and we will flip that DIP switch to the up position. One other thing that I did at the end of the last episode was update the firmware on this card. And you'll know from the show notes that I kind of goofed up the syntax slightly, and so it didn't actually update. So I've successfully done the update, and I'll have a link in the show notes to the Reactive Micro Wiki page, which gives the instructions for how to update the firmware. Let's go ahead now and put it into the IIGS. My IIGS is a ROM 1, so I have to put the card into slot 3. And if you have a ROM 0, that's the same thing. If you have a ROM 3 IIGS, you can put it in any slot from 1 through 6. So I'm going to go ahead and put it in. And if you recall, you need to make sure that the HDMI port is towards the keyboard. And there's also a little note here that says towards keyboard. You definitely don't want to put it in backwards. So we're just going to put that into slot 3, just like that. And then I'll plug in my HDMI cable. And then we should be good to go. My IIGS, as you can see, it doesn't have any other cards in the slots right now. I have a 8 meg RAM card here. And this is from Byte Boosters. And then finally, I have a W drive plugged into the DB19 connector in the back. I'm going to go ahead and boot up my IIGS here. And when it first starts up, it's just going to go to the W drive main menu. All right, so you can see that at least the HDMI is working great from the A2FPGA card. I can see the scan lines, which those are currently enabled. And the resolution looks really good. It's actually crystal clear here. The blue looks the same as the blue on a regular RGB CRT. Let's go ahead and actually the first thing we need to do is make sure that we've enabled Mockingboard. So I'm going to hit the Control Open Apple Escape key to bring up the IIGS control panel. I'm going to go to the control panel. I want to go to slots. And by default, slot 4 is marked as the mouse port, because that's what's built into the IIGS. However, we want the A2FPGA card to have a Mockingboard card in slot 4, even though the actual card is in slot 3. That should be the only slot that we need to change. So let's go ahead and hit enter and to save it, and then we'll quit and quit again. And then let's just bring up Total Replay, just because that's always a good kind of canary in the coal mine test. Okay, and it says Mockingboard in slot 4 and it's stereo. So again, we'll try Skyfox. The graphics, by the way, look fantastic in this. I don't see any artifacts or anything strange. Okay, so that all looks good. Let's try Rastan. So this is the game by John Brooks, and this is a really good kind of test of the IIGS, both graphics and sound. And let's see, press escape for 29 lives. Okay, sure. All right. So that looks beautiful. I don't see any artifacts there or anything. That the graphics look fantastic. Let's go ahead and we'll just say one player. One thing I noticed with Rastan is that the sound is still coming out of the Apple II speaker rather than going through the HDMI. I asked Ed Anuff about this and he confirmed that the Ensoniq sound is still just going through the speaker. He is working on a fix for it, and hopefully if he can get that working, he'll just do a firmware update and then the sound will also route through the HDMI. Let's go ahead and try Arkanoid 2. That has really good graphics just like Rastan. And also like Rastan, the sound comes through the Ensoniq chip, so that won't actually go through the HDMI. A couple people asked me what the text looked like with the A2FPGA, and this is 40 column text here on the Apple IIGS. And as you can see, it looks crystal clear if we just do a simple program. So that is 40 column. Now let's switch to 80 column here. And again, it looks as sharp as can be. I don't see any artifacts or strange fringing or anything like that. I hope this video answered some more questions about the A2FPGA card. I'll have a link in the show notes for where you can get the card. Full disclosure, I did buy the card from Reactive Micro, and I'm going to make use of it in either my Apple IIGS or my Apple IIe. If you're not currently a subscriber, I'd really appreciate it if you hit the subscribe button below. Also, I have a Patreon if you'd like to support me that way. Once again, thanks for watching.